It's Miss Amelia at the library, and today we are here for another story time. So go ahead and get out your story time kit, and if you haven't picked up one of these at the Columbus or Saluda Library, make sure you do, because inside there's a shaker, a scarf, and a lyric packet, so you can follow along with the songs that we sing later on in story time. Today's story time is all about Eric Carle. And Eric Carle is a children's author, and he writes books. That's what an author is. So today I'm going to read you the story, The Very Busy Spider by Eric Carle. Early one morning, the wind blew a spider across the field. A thin, silky thread trailed from her body. The spider landed on a fence post near a farmyard and began to spin a web with her silky thread. "Nay, nay," said the horse. "Want to go for a ride?" The spider didn't answer. She was very busy spinning her web. "Moo, moo," said the cow. "Want to eat some grass?" The spider didn't answer. She was very busy spinning her web. "Baa, baa," bleated the sheep. "Want to run into meadow?" The spider didn't answer. She was very busy spinning her web. "Ma, ma," said the goat. "Want to jump on the rocks?" The spider didn't answer. She was very busy spinning her web. "Oink, oink," grunted the pig. "Want to roll in the mud?" The spider didn't answer. She was very busy spinning her web. "Woof, woof," barked the dog. "Want to chase a cat?" The spider didn't answer. She was very busy spinning her web. "Meow, meow," cried the cat. "Want to take a nap?" The spider didn't answer. She was very busy spinning her web. "Quack, quack," called the duck. "Want to go for a swim?" The spider didn't answer. She had now finished her web. "Cock-a-doodle-doo," crowed the rooster. "Want to catch a pesky fly?" And the spider caught the fly in her web, just like that. "Who, asked the owl. "Who built this beautiful web?" The spider didn't answer. She had fallen asleep. It had been a very busy day. The end.
Happy Tuesday, everybody. It's Jen with Polk County Public Libraries, and I'm very excited about our Eric Carle story time today. He's one of my favorite authors and illustrators, and his birthday is this week. So if you know me, you know that this is one of my favorite books. It's called The Very Hungry Caterpillar, and I read it a lot in story time. And I'm going to read it again today. In the light of the moon, a little egg lay on a leaf. One Sunday morning, the warm sun came up and pop! Out of of the egg came a tiny and very hungry caterpillar. He started to look for some food. On Monday, he ate through one apple, but he was still hungry. On Tuesday, he ate through two pears, but he was still hungry. On Wednesday, he ate through three plums, but he was still hungry. On Thursday, he ate through four strawberries, but he was still hungry. On Friday, he ate through five oranges, but he was still hungry. On Saturday, he ate through one piece of chocolate cake, one ice cream cone, one pickle, one slice of Swiss cheese, one slice of salami, one lollipop, one piece of cherry pie, one sausage, one cupcake, and one slice of watermelon. That night, he had a stomachache. The next day was Sunday again. The caterpillar ate through one nice green leaf, and after that, he felt much better. Now he wasn't hungry anymore, and he wasn't a little caterpillar anymore. He was a big, fat caterpillar. He built a small house called a cocoon around himself. He stayed inside for more than 2 weeks. Then he nibbled a hole in the cocoon, pushed his way out, and he was a beautiful butterfly. The end.